All right, well, welcome back, everybody. Yes, we're back in the garage and we're gonna do another project. And no, it's not a sign. Don't worry, there's plenty of signs coming up. Signs that I've, don't know why I'm doing that. Signs that I've made in the past that videos I haven't released yet. Some of those are the NFL ones. Actually, most of them are the NFL ones. So stay tuned for those. So this is another project from my friend Ernie. For those of you who follow Justin Scard, you will have seen Ernie probably several times. More recently, Justin had Ernie in a video showing off Ernie's display cabinet that he has in an antique store in Orange Circle, which is near, you know, sort of near Disneyland. In that display cabinet, Ernie sells some Bob Gurr merchandise. Justin Scard has a few things for sale in there as well, and other Disney-related stuff. But what he wants is a little TV. Not a TV, but like a fake TV that he could put his iPad in and display Disney cartoons. So somebody has to make the TV, and I might as well be me. So let's get to it. Foot and Kiss, go check them out. P-H-U-N, Kiss. Make some cool stuff. Going to be using my new toy today. It's a battery powered trim router, and I got a rabbiting bit in there, and we're going to make a rabbit along the inside edges, front and back. Walt goggles, not to be confused with Disney Walt. By the way, I made a t-shirt for that. Check it out, it's in the description down below.
Thank you.
my handy dandy death guide over from makeawoodsign.com.
Thank you.
So I went ahead and painted that little piece of wood that I was rounding over. This is actually going to become the little antenna on the top of the TV. It's like a little fake rabbit ear, old style antenna. Some of these little plastic rubber coated tips or whatever. Put it right on top. Stick a little Gorilla Glue. Thank you.
A Libby's doll.
And look what Ernie found. It's an Uncle Ben's plush. It's a plush piece of rice with a tie.
You'll make a chain that can match this one.
It actually matches the color of your shirt.
Oh yeah, it's got a nice patina on there. This coming home with...
What are you doing?
I was just starting to sometimes.
This is my channel.
Oh, this is your channel.
My channel.
Oh, this
it's
is
your own. Hello, and welcome to video number 2 for Ernie. And this one's for Ernie as well. I forgot I had that. I remember I have that now. So this is gonna go about right there. I'm gonna cut more strips. Let's just, for the sake of argument. Alright guys, we're over at Porter Barnwood over in Phoenix, and I'm here with Ernie, and I just finished this TV, and what do you think?
This is amazing. Every time Jason makes me something new, it's my new favorite thing, and this is definitely my new favorite thing. I saw something similar to this that I wanted, and this is actually the design is much nicer. There's no slots in this, so it looks just like a little retro TV. And what's nice about it is that this comes right off. There's a very strong magnet on it, and then underneath it holds my iPad. It just pops right in. And then underneath that is a Bluetooth speaker, which can connect, you know, Bluetooth to the iPad. It can also connect with a power cord. So if I did want to leave this running for long term, and didn't want to depend on the charge, it could be plugged in, and then one cord could come out of the back, which is awesome because it's exactly what I wanted. And this was done in a record amount of time. Not to say every project's gonna be that quick,
but yeah,
but I'm really lucky to have gotten.
I think
there's
like a 2-week turnaround, really.
So. Yeah. So, and you know, you can play whatever you want on the iPad, but of course, this looks great if you play black and white footage. And I have a booth, an antique booth in Old Town Orange. And I thought it would be fun, we sell Disney items, I thought it would be fun to have this in the booth to attract people when they come by. And clearly everyone here was amazed by it,
right.
So I know that it's definitely going to attract a lot of attention and probably a lot of phone calls from the manager telling me that people want to buy it. But
so
this
we'll
is mine, and this is definitely going on the plane as a carry-on with me because, this is awesome and love this thing. So great job.
Oh, thank you. And I just want to mention we're here for a Bob Gurr event, actually, which of course is Ernie's collaborator and friend, and obviously Ernie runs the Waltland Tours. And I just want to thank Thomas Porter for letting us film here and for having Bob out here. So I guess until next time, like,
subscribe.
Like, subscribe. Until next time.
Bye.
Kind of messing my own thing. All right, so here we are. We're over at Potter Barn. Porter Barn. I keep wanting to say Potter. Let's do that again. All right, guys. We're over at... I can't even say that. Porter Barn. Why do I want to see Potter?
Well, because of like pottery or pottery.
Pottery barn. Here you go.
And then there's potato barn.
Potato barn. Yeah. I've heard of that one.
But yeah, Porter Barnwood.
Porter Barnwood. Porter Barnwood. And I know this. I just keep saying Potter.
Yeah.
So, we're looking at the pictures. That's some of our shop work.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Oh, great. That's me on the left. I used to drink this as a kid when I got it.